Tony Abbott tried to deceive the Australian people. He did that by promising no cuts to health and education, and yet in the 2014 budget, he took the hatchet to schools and hospitals. Malcolm Turnbull's using a slightly more sophisticated tactic. Rather than trying to deceive the Australian people, he's trying to distract them. He's trying to distract them by throwing up this proposal to grant powers to the states to raise income taxes. Now, the impact is effectively the same. It is that we will see huge cuts to schools and hospitals. The truth is that while Tony Abbott used deception as a tactic, while Malcolm Turnbull's now trying to use distraction as a tactic, it comes from the same place, and it comes from a place where the coalition's worldview is that they believe in a user pay system when it comes to schools and hospitals. They believe that is the responsibility of the individual rather than those of us who understand that the most efficient and effective way of funding schools and hospitals is by raising revenue and the collective provision of those services. So that's what is at the heart of this debate that will be discussed at COAG right now. The notion of granting those powers to the states is simply a distraction. It's a more sophisticated version of what Tony Abbott did in the lead up to the 2013 election. The Greens have a very clear view, and it's a view that is supported by the majority of Australians. We believe it's a responsibility of all of us to raise revenue to ensure that we provide an education and a health system that's available to everybody. And that's why we've proposed a range of revenue measures, ending those unfair tax breaks in the super system, ending unfair tax breaks in the property market, making multinational tax avoiders pay their fair share of tax, ending unfair subsidies like the inequitable rebate that subsidises the private health insurance industry. It's really critical that we do those things so that we can ensure that we see education and healthcare as an investment in our people, in the community and the future.